Verna has been in our market for more than a decade. It's one of the most reliable and practical cars out there. So, how is the fifth generation Verna? Let's find out. One of the most striking features of a modern Hyundai is its design. Most car manufacturers adopt design cues of their flagships and try to incorporate this design down their lineup. This is a challenging task, and not every car so designed may end up looking good. But Hyundai has always been successful in this execution. The fifth generation Verna makes huge strides in the exterior design department. The front fascia is classy and features Hyundai's signature cascading grille with sleek new projector headlamps. The reworked bumper houses projector fog lamps with chrome surrounds. From the sides, with the sloping roofline, the Verna has a coupe-like silhouette. There are strong character lines running through the entire side profile. The new Verna is both wider and longer than the outgoing car. The top trims get this stylish 5-spoke diamond-cut alloys. The rear too has undergone major cosmetic changes, the most striking being the LED tail lamps. The redesigned bumper with black inserts looks sporty. Step inside, you will experience a whole lot of changes. Not only in terms of design and layout, but also in build quality. The fit and finish is excellent. Hyundai has also provided interiors with all the bells and whistles, including ventilated seats. This is not some kind of gimmick, but rather a handy feature. The smart trunk opener is also worth mentioning. Beneath the center console, there's a 12-volt socket, USB port, aux input, and a small space for keeping your stuff. Now we get rear AC vents, and the housing has a USB socket for charging your phone, but misses out on cubby space. We also get rear armrests with cup holders, height adjustable rear headrest, retractable privacy curtains, auto dimming IVRM, sunroofs, and whatnot. The list goes on. The infotainment system is fairly responsive and UI is simple. It comes with Bluetooth connectivity, navigation, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and reverse parking camera with steering guidelines. Sound is pushed through 4 speakers and 2 tweeters. User experience is quite good. Front seats offer decent lumbar and underthigh support, but the steering wheel can only be adjusted for rake. Talking about the rear seats, it also provides adequate lumbar and underthigh support. Knee room is generous, but what's lacking is the space. The slanting roofline also limits the headroom, especially for the middle passenger. This could be a problem for people who are 6 feet tall or above. So powering the new Verna are the tried and tested 1.6-liter petrol and diesel engine options. No 1.4-liter engines this time around, and both engines are mated to either a 6-speed manual transmission or a 6-speed automatic transmission. So the petrol engine churns out 123 PS of power and 154 Nm of torque. The power is spread evenly across its rev range, and it is very responsive even at lower revs. And the engine isn't as aggressive as it may seem on the paper, but instead the power delivery is so smooth and it is very easy to drive. So the diesel engine is also the same unit which has been powering the fluidic Verna, which churns around 128 PS of power and 265 Nm of torque. So, is that all about the diesel engine? Well, not exactly. Even though the power figures are almost the same, there is a difference in the tuning. This engine has a larger torque. Therefore, it is able to produce the same amount of torque at a lower 1500 RPM and retains the torque till 3000 RPM. Whereas the older engine, the torque was only produced from 1900 and retained only till 2600 RPM.
Therefore, with the old Verna, there was noticeable lag below 2000 RPM. So we have to maintain the RPM accordingly, which required more gear shifts. This was a problem in city drives as it required some getting used to. Now, this issue is eliminated.
So, with the revised tuning, the engine is more responsive than before even at lower revs. It gets active soon after 1500 RPM, and there is a significant improvement in the in-gear acceleration. So, as a whole, the engine feels a lot more energetic now, and Hyundai has done a commendable job here.
Not to mention the petrol engine, it's also a very good performer, but it doesn't have the punch of the diesel. This engine is tuned to maximize fuel economy and driving comfort. But hey,
you can still roam around below 40 kmph in 4th gear without any hiccups. To get this engine to perform, you need to work a little more. Accelerate past 3000 rpm, here the engine starts to get aggressive and there's plenty of usable power on tap until 6500 rpm. So, there you go. Gear shifting is buttery smooth, thanks to the short throws and light clutch. The 6th gear is an added advantage. The engines feel unstressed even at high speeds. Oh, I forgot to mention refinement. Both engines are simply the best in its class. The gear ratios are well optimized for our driving conditions. While the 6-speed automatic transmission is a torque converter and has fixed gear ratios, it gets the job done. As long as you are light on the gas pedal, the gearbox operates quite well. But when you demand for more power, say for a sudden overtake, the gearbox takes time to respond and the transition is a bit jerky. Neither does it have a sport mode nor paddle shifters. At this point, we feel Hyundai should have opted for a CVT instead. The new electronic power steering is very light at slow speeds that makes it more convenient for daily usage. The feedback is satisfactory. There's an overall improvement in the ride quality and handling. With the application of hydraulic rebound stoppers on the front suspension and the revised vertical orientation of the rear shock absorbers, the car feels composed. Bumps and potholes are absorbed well. Also, the car feels more confident around corners as there is minimal body roll. The newer platform also ensures better stability at high speeds and isn't as wobbly as the older car. Verna may not be the best in terms of handling and dynamics, but has undergone vast improvements over the previous generation. The brake pedal is a bit numb. New Verna has ventilated disc brakes on the front and drum brakes at the rear. The braking performance was decent. We even attempted panic braking at 110 kmph. The car stopped without any fuss. On the safety front, dual airbags and ABS comes as standard, with the top trim getting 6 airbags. Now 50% of the body structure is made out of advanced high-strength steel. So to conclude, new Verna comes with best-in-segment engine options, safety kit and features. The pricing is also aggressive. All these makes Verna a compelling package. So our verdict is, the legacy is redefined.